arvoisarehtori, vararehtori, dekaanit, hyvä yliopistoyhteisö, naiset ja herrat. The professorship that I am honored to serve in at University of Turku is in mathematics with a focus on complex systems. I would like to share with you a few thoughts on some of the many facets of complexity. My starting point is the observation that the quest for understanding, disentangling, and managing complexity is of deep general interest in science, technology, and in the society in general. I will make a few brief points in this lecture about how mathematics and computing contribute to this quest, especially in the age of artificial intelligence, dominated by the availability of big data and large-scale computations. I will give a few examples on how mathematics and artificial intelligence are used to address complexity in medicine, a field that I am particularly interested in. There is a profound sense of appreciation in mathematics for elegance, seen in well-organized structures laying at the foundations of complex constructions, or in simple, elementary arguments for why a certain property holds in a dizzyingly diverse array of processes and contexts. Mathematicians even talk about the beauty of a theorem with the same admiration that one may have about the beauty of a painting or of a piece of music or of literature. Paul Erdős, a central figure of modern mathematics, even talked about the book in which God keeps the most beautiful proof of every theorem that some lucky mathematician may catch a glimpse of sometimes, leading to a particularly elegant mathematical argument. Mathematics typically approaches complexity from this standpoint of elegance and tries to untangle it through as simple foundations as possible. This is particularly insightful into the nature of complexity and has had a profound influence on many fields. Professor Moshe Vardi from Rice University recently wrote in the communications of the ACM about the seductive power that mathematical beauty and elegance has had in science. An example of this type of influence is in medicine, in the systems-based approaches to understand complex diseases and to identify new drug targets. The idea is to combine different types of biomedical data, molecular details, clinical information, pharmacokinetic drug target data, into comprehensive disease networks. These networks may then be analyzed in the framework of graph theory to identify special topological motifs, such as highly connected nodes, nodes that are unusually close to a certain part of the graph, nodes that are traversed by a disproportionate number of paths in the graph, or edges that are key to its connectivity. The search for these mathematical motifs pinpoints areas of potential clinical significance for understanding the basis of complex disease and/or for suggesting new potential drug targets. There is no a priori reason why nodes with special mathematical properties should be clinically significant, and yet this works well. Successful examples include the identification of biomarkers for different types of cancer, type 2 diabetes, and neurodegenerative diseases. Another example of the mathematical approach to complexity is in the study of computational complexity in theoretical computer science. In understanding the borders between solvable and unsolvable problems, between feasible and impractical solutions, and between correct and incorrect implementations. The problem here is to understand the boundaries of computing independently of its physical implementation, in other words, independently of what kind of processors, memory, or communication protocols one uses to implement computing. Perhaps the most celebrated problem in theoretical computer science is the question whether the computational complexity classes of P and NP are equal. The problem has been listed as one of the 7 Millennium Prize problems by the Clay Mathematics Institute, each of them carrying an award of $1 million for solving it. The P versus NP problem is an almost 50-year-old open problem that's a quest for questions whose solutions may require an impossibly long time to find, but given a candidate solution, one can efficiently check it for correctness. So difficult to find a solution, but easy to check any candidate solution. To claim the $1 million award, one can, for example, choose the so-called Hamiltonian path problem of finding a tour through a network of cities that visits all cities exactly once. Some of the connections may be unidirectional. It's obviously easy to check whether a proposed tour does visit each city exactly once. To claim the award, it's enough to prove that finding a tour in an arbitrary network cannot be done efficiently. That is to say, the challenge is not to show that the prize applicant couldn't find an efficient algorithm, but rather that one doesn't exist independently of any current or future technology. Complexity from the point of view of mathematics is thus a concept to be explained through elegant and beautiful theories, offering a deep, detailed insight into the source of the complexity and ultimately a path to reducing it to a number of elementary general principles. Artificial intelligence proposes a complementary approach. Perhaps we sometimes cannot and need not explain complexity in all details, but rather it's enough to manage it, to learn patterns from it, even if we don't fully understand how or why they are formed, and to be able to extrapolate them to statements or predictions about yet unseen inputs. Artificial intelligence is without a doubt one of the most hyped terms at the moment, highly esteemed and feared at the same time, and seen as a transformative force in virtually any field of activity. It proposes the automation of many processes, powered by the ability to learn patterns from massive amounts of data, leading to the possibility to anticipate solutions to new problems. The focus is on managing complexity and not necessarily solving complexity, learning from it to offer efficient and scalable solutions. Its impact in the last few years is clear both in academia and in the society. Only a few weeks ago, we've learned that the Turing Award 2018, the equivalent of the Nobel Prize for Computing, was awarded to Joshua Benjo, Geoffrey Hinton, and Lian Li Kan for their contributions to deep learning, a branch of artificial intelligence. In the society, we see the impact of AI in autonomous self-driving cars, in nearly fluent automatic translation systems, in high-quality image recognition, in artificial chat systems and online customer support, in recommender systems able to learn and predict our taste in music, movies, or books in more details than we could ourselves describe it. The benefits of AI in medicine, in identifying treatment strategies for complex diseases, are undeniable. We already have a diversity of examples where AI models have been built to predict the grade of a cancer tumor and the potential of a certain treatment line for it. My group and I demonstrated recently how a diversity of molecular and clinical data sources may be combined into comprehensive disease-specific interaction networks and how they can be used to identify combinatorial drug therapies for those diseases. Our computational predictions for therapy strategies for breast, pancreatic, and ovarian cancer are well aligned with standard clinical treatment lines for those diseases. This opens the door to precision medicine, where molecular, clinical, and image data of an individual patient may be combined to predict efficient therapeutic solutions uniquely suited for that patient. The way this works is that a patient walks in the clinic and has her molecular and clinical data collected. Her data is then analyzed by AI algorithms with access to data of many other similar patients to identify the most effective therapy strategy uniquely tailored to her molecular and clinical context. This is a particularly exciting avenue of research in Finland, where we have top quality biobanks, molecular and clinical data repositories. The opportunities for the medical system as a whole, and especially for patients, cannot be underestimated. Being able to anticipate the best line of treatment for a given patient based on massive evidence about other similar patients, recognizing the imminent onset of drug resistance even before it becomes detectable, are now becoming concrete possibilities. The elegance of mathematics in understanding the detailed foundations of complexity and the pragmatism of artificial intelligence in learning patterns of complexity on the basis of past experience are likely to become tightly intertwined in the very near future. We are currently in a pioneering age of artificial intelligence with exciting new proofs of concepts. As the field matures, the need for a deep understanding of the basis of the solutions it offers will become a driving force for the development of AI. The mathematical backbone of AI will likely strengthen in the future to offer to AI solutions the support needed to improve their practical deployment. Being able to answer why a certain solution is being identified and offering it a mathematical proof companion will be a key factor in the wider applicability of AI and will help to boost the public's trust in those systems. So how will this work in terms of the mathematics needed in these fields? The AI world for mathematicians is one dominated by graph theory, combinatorics, dynamical systems, statistical models, probabilistic estimates, approximation algorithms. It shouldn't be surprising that all these exciting applications in, say, self-driving cars, precision medicine, or recommender systems are reduced by mathematicians to equations. It was recognized already by von Goethe about 200 years ago that, I quote, "Mathematicians are a sort of Frenchmen. Whatever you say to them, they translate into their own language, and then it's immediately something quite different." One last point I want to mention is the future of work and some implications for the education that we are offering. It's already evident that the nature of most type of work is being rapidly disrupted by automation fueled by artificial intelligence. There are brand new opportunities in many fields of activities, and this change is likely to accelerate even more in the next few years. New skills are needed that go beyond the classical boundaries of a profession towards understanding and taking advantage of the opportunities opened up by the new age of artificial intelligence. This is not about learning how to use new devices, but rather about understanding how one's own profession is being transformed. This is also not about becoming better or more efficient at what we currently do, but rather about maintaining a significant role in the professional landscape of tomorrow. There is a strong need for our educational programs to integrate these opportunities in their own context to help our graduates become fluent in these new skills as they are in those of their own profession. I think that minor subjects and optional courses are no longer enough, and that instead, a deep contextualized integration of computing and artificial intelligence is needed throughout our education. Thank you.